कर्तुं नमः काय सूर्य कोटि सौभगो निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्व कार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वती नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणे विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाव्य संपृक्तौ वागर्थप्रतिपत्तये जगतः पितरौ वन्दे पार्वती परमेश्वरौ येनाक्षरसमाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृत्स्नं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनेय नमः वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयं धातुर्ब्रह्मैव संप्रोक्त जीवाख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृसुवन्तादिर्धातुर्ब्रह्मात्मने नमः। शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमामाद्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीम् अभयदां जाढ्यान्धकारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां विजजतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्दे तां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदां नत्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां पुण्यां करोमि पाणिनीयप्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदीम्। सो नेक्स्ट सूत्र हियर इज दि हल संधि इज विसर्जन्यस्य सह अनुवृत्ति इज खरी संहितायाम। टू डिलीट दिस या सो विसर्जनीय विसर्ग वी गेट्स अ सकार आदेश व्हेन व्हेन फॉलोड बाय खर। So example there is what we came from the earlier, the samskarta itself there visarjanyasya saha, so you can get double sakara, sam sakara then sakara, but then there is an apuada. What is the apuada? The following sutra vashari visarjanyasya visarjaniha samhitayam sakara which is prapta by the earlier sutra for the visarga has an optional apavada of visarga, meaning visarjaniya when followed by what earlier there was khar, so shar is part of khar, so visarga which is followed by khar should be replaced by sakara, but if that khar which is following is a shar letter then it becomes the replacement is optional. Why optional? Because it gives an optional visarga. So sakara is one paksha, visarga is another paksha, meaning visarga will remain the same when followed by a shar letter or can take sakara adesha. If it takes sakara adesha based on what is the shar letter following, there will be, there can be another sandhi. So what happens is that so there was no vartika there, but anyway, so that's an optional replacement by visarga itself, meaning visarga will remain visarga. Why a replacement of visarga has been given? Because sakara was prapta, therefore, otherwise it is not saying visarga will not change. The sutra says that visarga will be replaced by visarga, not by sakara. That's the meaning there. Thereby there is an optionality. So then there is a vartika below that sampunkanam so vaktavyaha. So why do we need this in a recap? Because sam, pum and kan, they also have a visarga in the prakriya. They'll also have a visarga when makara or nakara, they are replaced by something which will become a visarga. Then what will happen? Then this sakara is compulsory. Then the sakara replacement for that visarga is compulsory. That is the idea. So the visarga of sam, pum and kan. Sam, pum and kan don't have visarga right now, but in the prakriya they'll be replaced by ru, etc., and then they'll have finally this repha will be replaced by sakara which will become visarga, then it can be replaced by visarga which can become a sakara or a visarga as per the earlier option which was made available. But if it is a visarga which is belonging in a sam, pum or kan, then that visarga should be mandatorily be replaced by sakara. That is the vartika here. So after sam, the example of pum can be taken, but sam is the example here as you upasara, sam plus karta. So we have got this sam, ru is the replacement sam, there is a sudagama, then there is a ru, then this ru ukara, after anubandhal upa there will be repha. This repha, after this ru, there is this ru is the cause for the initial letter बिजनेस प्रिसीडिंग लेटर टू टेक इधर अनुनासिक और अनुस्वार. सो ऑल दीज आर ऑप्शन वी सॉ इन द लास्ट पार्ट. नाउ वॉट इज बींग सेड इज दैट दिस विसर्ग विच इज दिस रेफा विच हैज बिकम विसर्ग बाय खरवसानयोर विसर्जनीय रह पदस्य एंड देन बाय अलोंत्यस्य द रेफा ऑफ रू विच इज द रू रिप्लेसमेंट फॉर मकार ऑफ सम. सो सम सम परिभ्याम करोतु भूषणे समसुटि रूह. सो दिस रू विच हैज कम बिकॉज ऑफ दिस सुट एंड देन दैट रेफा ऑफ द रू इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय विसर्ग. दैट विसर्ग सिंस दैट विसर्ग इज वॉट इट इज विसर्ग ऑफ सम. जस्ट बिकॉज सम मकारा हैज समहाउ लैंडेड एज इफ विद द फॉर्म ऑफ सह डज नॉट मीन दैट दिस विसर्ग इज नॉट इन सम. इट इज द सेम सम. सो दैट सम विच इज पार्ट ऑफ संपुंकानां सो वक्तव्य विसर्जनीयस्य सह. सो दि सकारा विच इज अ रिप्लेसमेंट ऑप्शनली बिकॉज दि अदर ऑप्शन इज विसर्ग. नाउ इट विल नो लॉन्गर बी प्राप्त. वॉट यू हैव अ मैंडेटरी रिप्लेसमेंट ऑफ सह शरी परे. सो शरी परे इट वॉज प्राप्त खरी देन खरी देन शरी शरी इट वॉज विसर्ग वॉज ऑप्शनल एंड सकार वॉज प्राप्त बाय खरी. नाउ इट इज बींग सेड एज बिकॉज इट इज विसर्ग ऑफ द सम पुम और कान देर फोर इट शुड बी रिप्लेस बाय सकार अलोन देर बाय यू गेट संस्कर्ता. बाय द वे लास्ट पार्ट आई सेड सम 70 फॉर्म्स. 70 इज एन ऑड नंबर. I must have mistaken 17 for 70. There may be 17 forms or something. So anyway, it is just an exaggeration. Consider that samskara, samskruta, all these, samskarta, all these have several forms. That was the uddesha there. I jumped the gun and made a statement 70. Perhaps the memory is from Idagama, that 70 is not the number. Maybe 17 or whatever the forms are. Those who are interested in such kind of research, they can do it. I am particularly not, so just correcting the mistake that I made. So Idagama 70 is a number which has got stuck with fear, because our Swamiji, when he was teaching Vyakarana, he says, I'll not touch all the Idagama sutras. I didn't study the Lagu Prakriya, I studied the Ashtadhyayi Prakriya. So there he said that we'll not go through Idagamas, because Idagamas we'll go through a couple of sutras, important sutras, but not all the sutras, because Idagama is a very complex section. That Itagama has 70 sutras. So perhaps that's the number where it has come from. Wherever there is fear or some large number, 70 comes into the mind. That's my problem. Okay. So moving on, the samskarta. So you see samskarta here, anuswara paksha. When you take an anuswara paksha and not the anunasika, then what will happen? You will get samskarta. Our focus here in this sutra is this particular sakara, how this has come. The first sakara, not the second sakara is the nimitta, and this first sakara has come in because of this vartika. So vartika has caused this sakara, which is sam antargata sakara. Similarly for pum also, kan also, those sutras will come up now. Pumakhayam pare ru samhitayam. So ru is the adesha for what? For makara of pum. Just like for makara of sam there was a ru adesha, for pum also there is a ru pum makara also there is a ru adesha. When there is a khai letter following, which is ampara khai. Khai is qualified by ampara khai. Ampara is a visheshana for khai. So khai ampare khai kim bhavati pumaha makarasya ru adesha bhavati ityartha. So the ru is the replacement for pum. Now example is what? Look at this. Puman kokila. What is the form desirable? Pums kokila. How do you get this pums kokila form? Puman kokila, pum kokila. Where is this sakara coming from? So there also what will happen? Pum plus puman is the first case singular. So puman plus su, this is first case singular pratyaya. Then kokila plus su, this is a samasa. This is a first case singular. So then what? Krutadita samasascha pratipadikam. This karmadhara is what? Visheshanam visheshena bahulam tatpurusha samasa. So this tatpurusha is what? It is a karmadhara tatpurusha. Puman kokilaha. बिकॉज इज अ विशेषण विशेष भाव. कोकिला इज दी विशेष, पुमान इज विशेषण, इट्स क्वालिफाइंग दिस कोकिला. देन द एंटायर थिंग गेट्स दी प्रातिपदिक संज्ञा बाय कृत्यते समासाश्च. आई एम गोइंग थ्रू दिस सूत्रास बिकॉज देर बी सम संस्कार. वी हैव एज इट इज वन पाठा एवरी वीक एंड आई स्किप द लास्ट पाठा देर फॉर वंस इन टू वीक्स नाउ. सो दीज दे ऑल यू नो देर इज नो ऑप्शनल लोपा हियर. मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम मैंडेटरी लोपा ऑफ ऑल दी सूत्रास वी हैव स्टडीड. दैट इज वाई वी लैंडेड ऑन द रीकैप. सो कृत्तद्धित समासाश्च प्रातिपदिकम. सुपो धातु प्रातिपदिक लुक. देन द प्रातिपदिक विच हैज दिस सुप और धातु विच हैज सुप प्रत्यास दे अंडरगो लुक. सो दी सूज विल गो अवे. देन यू हैव पुम्स कोकिला. नाउ वी हैव कम अक्रॉस अ सिचुएशन वेयर दिस ककारा इज वॉट दिस पुम्स पुम्स पद देर दिस पुम्स सकार विल गो अवे. पुम्स इज दी प्रातिपदिक बट देन इट गोज अवे. सकार गोज अवे एंड देन यू गेट पुम संयोगांतस्य लोपः बिकॉज यू कैनॉट हैव दिस अनुस्वार विच विल बिकम विच इज एक्चुअली मकार. सो अनुस्वार कम्स बैक टू मकार बाय निमित्तापाये नैमित्तिकस्यापायः. द निमित्ता विच वॉज द कॉज निमित्ता विच कॉज द मकार टू बिकम अनुस्वार. वाय डिड मकार बिकम अनुस्वार बिकॉज इट वॉज फॉलोड बाय सकार. देर फोर मकार वॉज मेड अनुस्वार. नाउ दिस सकार संयोगांतस्य लोपः देर इज अ संयोग नाउ बिटवीन अनुस्वार एंड सकार दैट संयोग कैनॉट एग्जिस्ट बिकॉज वॉट बिकॉज दिस इज अ पद. बीइंग अ पद बीइंग वॉट काइंड ऑफ अ पद इट इज अ सुप्तिंगंतम पद. दिस एंटायर थिंग इज पद. जस्ट बिकॉज दिस सुप लुक दिस सू वेंट अवे. सुपो धातु प्रातिपदिक लुक देर बाय दिस सू वेंट अवे डज नॉट टेक अवे दी पदत्वम ऑफ दिस पुम्स. देर फोर दिस पदत्वम ऑफ पुम्स कॉज इज द पदांत सकार लोप. वाई बिकॉज इट इज इन अ संयोग इट इज अ कंजंक्ट. यू कैनॉट हैव अ कंजंक्ट कॉन्सनेंट एट द एंड ऑफ द पद दैट इज ए नियम. दे फोर संयोगांतस्य लोपः विल कॉज सकार लोप. वन सकार गोज अवे देन दैट सकार वॉज द कॉज फॉर मकार टू बिकम अनुस्वार. That makara will come back. So it is like, you know, the sakara is like a bully who made makara anuswara. So once the bully has gone, anuswara is back in its makara form. For easy understanding. So then that is nimitta apaye, naimitta kasya api apaya. It's a paribhasha. Now this makara will become ru by which sutra? By our sutra pumakhayamam. Khayyam pare. So this is our focus area for this sutra. Then this room ukara will go away anubandha lopa. Then repha that repha atra anunasika purvasya tu va. So va means you can get either anuswara or anunasika earlier. So that is paksha. So paksha you will get this anuswara not this paksha the other paksha which may be following. So there you have this. Yeah. So here you have anunasika. So either anunasika, this anunasika that you get, or you will get anunasika, anunasika para anuswara, not anunasika here. Here you will get anuswara. So either you will get anuswara. So earlier is the anunasika paksha, anunasika. This is the anunasika. The second paksha is what? Anuswara. Other than anuswara, what can anunasika, what can you get? You can get anuswara. So this ardhachandra or you will get a dot. The way you write, that is the difference. Pronunciation is unfortunately not clear in sampradaya, not retained well for most of us. Thereby what? You will get these two pakshas. Now, our sutra is over really, but you have to end to the pada. So what will happen here? Kharavasani or visarjaniya. So this repha will become visarga. Now this visarga which gets a sakara or visarga optionally because kakara is following. Kakara is part of what? Khar. Khapa chatata chatatav. Kapai shasasar. Then shar is also there, but this shar is what? Only what you have here? Khai and then there was a shar. So there is a shar here. But this visarga was optional. What was prapta earlier? This sakara. So now the sakara is made mandatory in the vartika, and thereby Visarga will be replaced by sakara. Sampunkanam sovaktavya. Although it is not really necessary because khari is there, but since this is a specific vartika, we are using that. Without the vartika, I see that you can get it because shar is not following, khar is following. So in khar paksha, there was no visarga prapta at all. Visarjanyasya visarga was not prapta really. But anyway, vartika is given, we use that vartika because sampumka are specifically mentioned. So it is given here, not only prevents vaikalpika visarjaniya, but also jivha mulya told by, which is going to come up later. So here for this pum particularly, this jivha mulya which was prapta will also go away. Of course in Tripadi you should look at the order of sutras and then see what is prapta, what is applicable, what is not. Okay, so moving on, there is another sutra which says what? Nachavya prashan ampare padasya ru sahitayam. So ru is the adesha. When is it the adesha and for what? Naha. Naha is shashti ekvachana. So nakarasya ru adesha bhavati. Kidrasya nakarasya? That which is a padanta nakara, because padasya is a padasya naha. So actually it will be what? Nakarantasya padasya. Nakarantasya padasya is by tadanta vidhi. But finally you will end up with the meaning as padanta nakarasya. How? Because padasya nakarasya is the meaning by alontyasya. Alontyasya is a paribhasha sutra which will apply after the tadanta vidhi. Yena vidhis tadantasya. So pada, which kind of pada? Pada is the substantive, adjective, visheshya. Visheshana is what? Naha. So you'll have to say what? Nakarasya. Nakarantasya padasya. Nakarantasya padasya, because naha is qualifying pada. So visheshana, visheshana will take the tadanta, the anta, anta shabda in the, by tadanta vidhi yena vidhi tadantasya. So nakarantasya padasya, but by alontya, alontyasya, the nakarantasya. Nantasya nakarantasya padasya. So the pada is nakara ending, all right, but what will take the adesha? The nakara will take the adesha by alontyasya. Therefore the end meaning will what will be? Padanta nakarasya. Padantasya nakarasya will be the artha. Although the visheshana is nakara, still you'll end up concluding that padantasya nakarasya. Although this pada is visheshya, which is not taking is tadanta vidhi. Tadanta vidhi is applied to nakara, visheshana, but still end meaning will be opposite to that by alontya. So you can directly make a jump. If you know enough of this, then you can directly make a vritti as not as nakarantasya padasya. You can say padantasya nakarasya. A shortcut method to understand. Those who have this samskara of making vritti from the ashtadhyayi sequence, they can make this shortcut. As a simple vritti, basic vritti to understand, most of the times you will be getting the basic meaning. So that's the benefit which I had offered to those who requested this laghu pata in Bangalore. I had said that instead of sticking to laghu, we can go through ashtadhyayi prakriya, through the same sequence. It will benefit because we know the sequence and we know what is anuvritti, and I have taught in that manner. Currently we are not going through ashtadhyayi because of this being a recap. This book I have not visited, it is too verbose, so I have to search which is, where is the exact line. I still haven't got used to it completely, but I am slowly getting used to this. So chavi, what kind of chavi? Chavpara. So chavi is following chavi, but chavi is ampara. Ampare chavi. Ampara is a visheshana for chavi. So that chav letter which is ampara, which is followed by am, that becomes nimitta for this padanta nakara to take ru adesha. That is the idea here. But what? It should be aprashan, meaning this pada should not be prashan shabda. It should be aprashan pada. So prashan varjita. So what is the example there? Not mentioned here. Okay, so here, sorry. Chakrin trayasva. Chakrin trayasya. Chakrin is chakrasya asti iti chakrin Vishnu. So Vishnu, Krishna, whoever it is carrying a chakra, Narayana. So trayasva. ప్లీజ్ ప్రొటెక్ట్ యూ, ప్లీజ్ ప్రొటెక్ట్ ఓ విష్ణు హే చక్రిన్ త్రాయస్వ. మధ్య పురుషే ఏకవచన సంబోధన ఇస్ చక్రిన్, హే చక్రిన్, భో చక్రిన్, భగో చక్రిన్. సో దాట్ చక్రిన్ నకార ఈజ్ అ నకారాంత సంబోధన విచ్ ఇస్ అ పద. నౌ దిస్ ఇస్ ఫాలోడ్ బై త్రాయస్వ దిస్ తకార. What is the rule there? So you look at this aprashan, that chakrin is not a prashan shabda, and is it followed by chav? What is chav? Khapha has to be dropped. Khapha chhatatav chhatatav kapai. Khapha chhatatav chhatatav. That much only, not kapai. Chav. So chhatatha chhatatav. So there you have these three from both of the vargas, second varga dvitiya and varga prathama. There the chhatata and chatata. So takara is included in that. Thereby what do you get here? You get chakrin. So chakrin. So there this nakara will be replaced by ru. By Naschafya, this is our sutra. So first sutra itself, this nakara is replaced by ru. Then ru ukara goes away, repha remains, and all these atra anunasika or pakshe anuswara, all that will apply, and then you will get what? This visarjaniyasya kharavasana visarjaniya, then visarjaniyasya sa. So chakrin strayasva. This is the with the anunasika or with anuswara, you will get chakrin strayasva. अप्रशान, सो आई स्किप थ्रू अप्रशान. देन नेक्स्ट सूत्र इज ऋण पे ऋण उभयता संहितायाम. दिस उभयता इज प्राप्त फ्रॉम दी अर्लियर सूत्र समवेयर, इट्स गिवन हियर 838. उभयतरक्षु, सो दैट हैज दी वर्ड उभयता. उभयता इज वॉट इन बोथ वेज. इन बोथ वेज मीनिंग विभाषा अन्यतरस्याम वा, इट फाइनली मीन्स वा. सो उभयता मीन्स बेसिकली इट मीन्स वा, मीनिंग इज वा. Paksha, so optionality is given for what? This ru to be a replacement for nakara of nrun. What is nrun? Nrun is dvitiya bahuvachana of nru shabda. So nru shabda, nru means nara really. So this nru in dvitiya bahuvachana will become nrun. So it is anukarana. Nrun has been mentioned here, it is anukarana, the sound of nru shabda in dvitiya bahuvachana. So but what kind of nrun nakara which is followed by pakara, pe pare, pakare pare, then optionally there is a, this optionality comes from ubhayata shabda. So you will get either what, nruru pakara and then or nrun. So nrun can also be there, nruru can also be there. So what is the example? Nrun pahi. So you protect he Vishnu or he Vishnu or he chakrin itself earlier. Nrun pahi, protect the people. So protect the people, naran pahi ityartha. So that nrun is the shabda. Nara and nru are the are different pratipadikas. So this nru shabda, when it is being used in plural, it will be nrun in dvitiya. So dvitiya bahuvachana nrun can be optionally it, this nakara can become ru because pe pare, pakare pare, pahi is following, pakara is following, thereby nruru pahi. Then nruru pahi, all this anunasika or anuswara are the pakshas as well. Now what happens is that this sutra we have already covered. What is our sutra really? The final form will be your nru visarga kharavasana visarjaniha nru pahi. Paksha also, there may be other option as to based on where it occurs in the sutra, we have to look at, but that is not the focus area and recap, so I'll move on. This was seen by the Vartika Kara, and the Vartika was given, not Vartika Kara per se, but yeah, you can say Vartika Kara. And Vedanta Vartika Kara is someone else. Here Vartika Kara is someone else. So in Vedanta it is Sureshwara Acharya. So kup vok kaf paucha. So this pronunciation of visarga before kakara or pakara. So at kakara, if kakara is following visarga, then visarga is replaced by what is called as jivha mulya. When pakara is following, then visarga is the replaced by what is called as upadmaniya. So the pronunciation is different. So when pakara is following this visarga, which is replaced by upadmaniya, upadmaniya has the sound of fakara. This is the only time when you have this Urdu fa, where in Urdu you have falam, they say falam, which has got ingrained into Hindi also. So Hindi they'll pronounce as falam. In Sanskrita or Shuddha Hindi it should be phalam, because it is from Sanskrita. In Sanskrita there is no fa sound. Only in Upadmaniya there is a fa sound. So this jivha mulya, there is a, it's a, like an ardha visarga, ak ak kind of a sound. When kakara is following, then visarga ak will sound like ak. The difference between this pha and pha, I'm sure you know. If you don't know, then pha is, in Sanskrita pha is labial, only oshta, only two lips are into play, kantoshta of course, but then in the sthana only the lips are into play. But in pha, this Urdu pha or this Upadmaniya pha, there is also the play of the danta. So it's also dantoshta. The lower row of teeth are going to touch the upper lip pha to get the pha sound. So that is the sound when you have pakara following the visarga. That visarga sounds like that, meaning it has replaced by upadmaniya. Therefore that visarga itself can be seen to be sounding as af instead of aha. You will have af or ak. That is the some in, you know, in Marathi or in Hindi they'll say ardha visarga or something like that. But this is the technical word, upadmaniya jivha mulya. So ka varge pa varge cha visargasya ak pau ak af pau staha chat visarga. So here so what are the pakshas finally you get? So you get this in the anunasika paksha, you will get these two. One without visarga, one with visarga. And without visarga means this visarga will sound upadmaniya, meaning replaced by upadmaniya. That is the first paksha. Second is what in that anunasika itself, visarga sound. Then these two are similar, except that instead of anuswara, you have anunasika. Sorry, instead of anunasika, you have anuswara. Then without the rutva itself is the first paksha, because rutva itself was given as optional. So you will not get either of the, none of the four pakshas will be there. There will be a fifth paksha without the rutva itself. Therefore, it will be just what? Nrun pahi. Simplest form. So those who do not know these rules, they can just say nrun, and then that is also fine. Tasya paramamreditam. Very difficult to pronounce or difficult to sound this word also. So this word itself is definitely before Panini Maharshi has retained that. So we have not heard this Amrita. I don't know how many I have heard. Even if I study this sutra, next time I visit it, I'll have to look up what Amrita means. So Amrita is a sanya introduced, that's all. Not very often used. It is it was existent before Panini Maharshi, therefore he retained that. Otherwise it is going to consume so many letters in the sutra. He wouldn't have created it. It was existent before Panini Maharshi. So tasya param kasya. So if you look at it, the Dvirukti, this is 812. 811 sutra says sarvasya dve. When there is a vipsa, when abhyasa has to be done, meaning vipsa as in you want to say you must have heard the phrase dine dine. Dine dine. Pratidinam. So when you say, want to say every day, so you will say dine dine. This is the style in Sanskrita. It may or may not be there in other regional languages. Every day. In English you cannot say day day. So you say every day. Like pratidinam. So one can say pratidinam also. One can say day by day. For that one can say in English every day you say day by day. Day in day out. Such phrases are there. In English the way the such phrases are there. And every language has its own specialty there. So this peculiarity in Sanskrit is dine dine. There is a vipsa, repetition. When that vipsa repetition to mean each and every of those units, that word is repeated, then in vipsa sarvasya dve. When you want to mean each and every entity, then that word standing for that entity, that pada is repeated. Repeated twice. So basically you will have, so repeated once meaning it is pronounced twice. So what do you have? Sarvasya dve. That sarvasya dve, once you have pronounced the word, let's say dina itself, dine dine, then this dine dine, the next word dine, second pronunciation dine, param, the second one, will be called as amreditam. That's all it means. It means the second pronunciation in the vipsa gets the name as amreditam. So that is a sanya sutra, nothing more to do, sanya sutra there, nothing much to do there. So diruktasya, diruktasya param amreditam syat. Now why do you need this? Because the next sutra being introduced by Lagukara uses the sanya amredita, that is the sanya pradesha, which is the 8312 sutra. It's a vidhi sutra. So there amredita sanya is used. Kan amredite. Amredite is in seventh case singular. So when amredita follows, meaning what? If you have uttered something twice and the second one has got the amredita sanya, then this rule will apply to what? It will apply to the first one, because amredita should be following in the second repetition, repeated word, second one should be following. So that will be following the first uccharana. So when one word is uttered twice, second should be following means the rule will apply to the first one. And for what is the form of the first one? Kan. So kim will decline in masculine as kakau ke, then kam kau kan. This kan is the second case plural form. Anukarana. It's a form just like nrun. Nrun is not the second case plural form in the sutra. In the sutra it is just first case, or it is sixth case singular with the shashti lupta. Here also it is, this is first case kan, but first case kan, kan is actually second case plural, but in the sutra it is sixth case singular. How? By lupta shashti. So lupta shashti, you can say to third second case plural uccharita as a padam in first case singular, and that is with lupta shashti. Therefore 2-3, which is actually in quoted as 1-1, that also is not the form. So 2-3 form is quoted as 1-1, and that 1-1 is actually lupta shashti nirdesha. Therefore 6-1 is the form, shashti ekvachana in the sutra. So sutra you will have to take kan means kan iti padasya, what? In shasti. Kan iti padasya. That will be the meaning of kan. Kan iti padasya nakarasya. That nakarasya, because padasya. So padanta nakan, that pada which is sounding as kan in second case plural, that nakara will get the ru adesha. So that nakara will get the ru adesha, meaning what? This kan, when you want to say kan kan, then it will become karu kan. That's what it means. Finally, this nakara will be replaced. This second one is amredita, meaning it is the vipsita. Vipsa, after vipsa, it is the second ucharita. Anyway, so much for the complexity of amredita. So you have kan kan, you will become karu kan, and then whatever is the process, finally you will land with what? Kams kan or kans kan. So these are the pakshas with anunasika or anuswara, but nakara will sound like sakara here finally. And what is this? See, this is prapta. The kuffo kaf paucha is prapta, jivha mulya is prapta, but negated by sampunkanam sovaktavyaha. So how did you get this sakara, not jivha mulya? Because visarga is followed by kakara. So that was given as a sutra which is prapta for this kankan, kamskan, but it will not apply because there is a vartika which is sampunkanam suvaktavya. So vartika has looked into what should be the karya, and then looking forward, it has, the vartika has been written. Now we look at the next sutra. Just give a minute. Tukagama. Okay, so anyway, there is a Tugagama section. So Checha, anyway, it is Halsandhi. Whatever be the Adesha, Agama, whatever it is, Checha is the Halsandhi Sutra. Checha Hraswasya Tuk Samhitayam. So in the Sandhi section itself, some Agama is Prapta, and that Agama will undergo Halsandhi. Therefore, it is presented in the Halsandhi. this is not really from Hal Sandhi. The sutra is not from Hal Sandhi, but in the Hal Sandhi section, it is brought in not to complete the form there. The pada derivation will have to undergo sandhi. But how did you get that? You got to the form because of something which is outside of Tripadi, outside of the Hal Sandhi. But Tugagama has come in. So here in the derivation, you look at this Checha. So what does the sutra say? Checha, Chepare, when Chakara is following, Hraswasya Tuk Samhitayam. So Hraswasya, Hraswantasya Padasya, Chakare Pare, Tugagama Bhavati. So the last letter of the last letter, which is what? Vowel. It's a Hraswa vowel. It's a short vowel that will take Tugagama. And Tugagama being Kit, Adyantau Takitau is a paribhasha there, whereby Kit being Kit, it will be at the Anta of the Stani. And Stani happens to be this Hraswa, Hraswasya. The last Hraswa vowel of the Pada will take the Tugagama Takara. Basically, Tugagama is Tuk. This is Tuk. Ukara also goes away, Kakara also goes away. Takara remains. So Takara will be added at the after the vowel, short vowel of the Pada. So what is the example? Shivaha. So Shivasya Chaya, Shiva Chaya. So Shiva, Shiva and, so Shiva plus Nyas, Chaya, Su, you will get Shiva and Chaya. Then Shiva Chaya, both are Padas. So this Shiva Akara is at the end of the Pada, which is Hraswa. And Che, Che Pare, Chakara is following. Therefore this Akara, Shiva A Akara, that Akara, this Akara here will take Tugagama. So it will become Shivat. Shivat Chaya, then that Takara will become Dakara by Jhalanjashvante, then Jakara by Stoshchunashchuhu, then that Chakara, Shiva will become So Jhalanjashvante will give Dakara and this Stoshchunashchuhu will give Jakara. This Jakara, now what happens to this Jakara? Kharicha Jhalamchar. So this Jhal Jakara, which is a Jhal, will be replaced by the first of the class Char when followed by Khar, because Chakara is a Khar letter. Therefore this Takara, which came in as a Tugagama, after going to Dakara, then becoming Dakara, becoming Jakara, finally it will become Chakara. So Takara end form will be Chakara. So Tugagama, you'll see Tugagama itself has come for Chakara, and finally that Chakara will become a Nimitta in Kharicha also and cause the Chartvam, and thereby you get Shivachaya. And what is said here, Tuk Sanhitaya, no optionality has been given. So it is mandatory. Now, the next sutra says Padantadva. So Padantadva, where Dirgha Che Tuk Sanhitaya. If it is a Padanta Dirgha, so at the end of the Pada, if it is not Hraswa, but it is Dirgha, then also what will happen, actually earlier was there a Padanta, no, only Hraswa. So that was earlier I just said Padasya, but it is not Padanta because in 6170 there is no Pada, it's an Anga Adhikara. So there should be Hraswa at the end, so this Hraswa may not be at the end of the Pada. So it can be within also. If it is within the Pada also, this Chakara which is following will cause the Hraswa to take Tugagama and it will become Chakara. Anyway, the example is not given. Laghu has given only one example. Therefore, I landed with you. Shiva is a Padanta example there in a Samasa. So, it may be applicable in non-Padanta also. Here, Padantadva, Vibhashaya, Dirgha. But between 61, before 6176, there are other sutras also where you, Dirgha comes in from. 6173 says Hraswa. But then 6176 has Dirgha from the earlier sutras, Anurti. Padantadva, Dirghat. Not after Hraswa, after Dirgha. Optionally, there is a Tugaga, so and there is a Sanhita situation. So, Tugagama, here it is said Anta Avayava. So, optionally, Tugagama, and Tugagama will go at the after the Dirgha. So, what is the example there? Lakshmi, Lakshmiaha Chayaha, Lakshmi Chaya. And since it is optional, you will get Lakshmi Chaya. So, Lakshmi Chaya or Lakshmi Chaya. With Tugagama, you will get this form. Without Tugagama, Vibhasha will get Lakshmi Chaya. So Hal Sandhi is over. Moving on to Atha Visarga Sandhi. So Visarga Sandhi. Visarga Sandhi Visarjaniyasya Saha. We have seen this sutra in passing. We have seen this as well. Khari Samhitayam. So Visarjaniyasya Saha. Sakara is the Adesha for the Visarga when followed by a Khar. So here Khari. Khari word example is Vishnuhu Trata. So Vishnu plus Su. Vishnu plus Su. Vishnu is the Pratipitika. Su is the Prathama Ekvachana Pratyaya. So Ukara goes away Sakar. So Vishnus Trata. This is how it is derived. It is called a Visarga Sandhi, but Visarga itself is not born. This Visarga is a question mark. It is an end form. Or is it the end form or not? That can be the question in Sandhi. So this Visarga, it gets the name Visarga Sandhi, but Visarga is not born at all. You see, look at this. Meaning is not born in the Pada, it is not born. When you say Vishnuhu plus Trata, that is how you see in the writing or in the uttered form when it is being taught. But then really in the sentence, it is not really Vishnuhu Trata. In derivation, it is Vishnus Trata. It has not become Vishnuhu Trata at all to be pronounced as the end of the Pada. So what has been said, Vishnuhu Trata, Vishnus plus Trata, Visarjaniyasya Saha. And this form, see here, Vishnuhu Trata, you cannot use Vishnu because Visarga will not become Sum. This is actually, when you derive, it has not been shown here. I have marked it as first case singular here, but she has skipped all the steps. Generally, she gives all the steps which are needed, but here she has not used. See, this is the issue of following a book which I have not gone through earlier. Here she has not given the process, Vishnus Trata. This is what you see in the sentence. Where is this Visarga at all? So Visarjaniyasya, in the derivation, you start with Supratya, Supratya. That Supratya, then you go through the steps, then you will get Visarjaniyasya Sa Khari Sanyuta. When Khar is following, then the Visarjaniyasya Sa, but Visarga was not there. Su Sakara was there. That Sakara, first it will have to become Ru, then it will become Visarga. Then that Visarjaniyasya Sa, Kharavasanayor Visarjaniya. First Rutva, and then all these sutras will apply. Finally, Visarjaniyasya Saha. So Vishnus Trata. But Tra Takara is what? It is a Khar letter. Therefore, this sutra was applicable Khari Samhitayam. Now Khar, we have seen earlier also, Khar includes Shar, and Shar provides certain kind of an optionality. This is the case here as well. So Vashari. So Vashari, when Shar is following, then Visarga optionally is replaced by Visarga. So Vashari Visarjaniyasya Visarjaniya Samhitayam. So either Visarga is replaced by a Sakara or Visarga is replaced by Visarga, because Sakara is Prapta, meaning it will not change. So Shari Visargasya Visargaha Va optionally. So Hari Shete, look at this, Hari Hi Shete. So what will happen? Two forms are given, no derivation has been done. Ru, then Su Sakara will become Ru, then Ru will become Visarga. Then that Visarga was replaced by Sakara could have been replaced by Sakara due to Khar letter falling, but Khar letter is also Shar letter, and Shar letter gives an optionality. So therefore Vashari will give you this Visarjaniyasya Visarga. So Hari hi Shete. Pakshe what? Meaning if you don't take this option, then Khar Shakara, not Shar Shakara. Shar Shakara, Shakara is a single Sakara, but are you seeing it as a Shar as you see here, or are you seeing it as Khar as you see here? If it is seen as a Khar and you have not taken the Vashari, then Visarjaniyasya Saha Khari, and then you will get Haris Shete. Then Haris Shete Sakara, that Sakara will undergo this Tosh Chunaschu, by that it will undergo Chutvam, and thereby it will become Shankar Shakara. So you will get Harihi Shete or Haris Shete. So this is a sutra which has not been covered, but it has been used. So Saso Jusho Ruhu. Saso Jusho Ruhu. Look at this. Saso Jusho Ruhu Padasya. Now in the Laghu Prakriya, you can say, see, this is a Visarga Sandhi. Generally, when you get this Jastva Sandhi, Rutva Sandhi, all that you talk about, Kutva. The name Kutva, Rutva, Ityadi are given based on what is the Adesha. But Visarga Sandhi is a little different. This Visarga Sandhi actually is Hal Sandhi. But what has happened? Visarga Sandhi is as a name to deal with the Visarga, not Visarga as an Adesha. So Visarga may or may not be the Adesha, but still it is seen as a Visarga Sandhi in Laghu Prakriya, Kaumudi Grantha. So Saso Jusho Ruhu. What is really the replacement is Ru. So when you have Pada, which is formed by Pratipadika plus Su Pratyaya, then it will have this Sakara at the end. first case singular, and this sakara as well as sajush, sajusho. So sajusho, sajush is the pratipadika there. Sajush means a friend. So that sajush form, I mean hardly used in this era, we don't hear the sajush. So mitram is the shabda, but that is the meaning. So paryayavachi shabda is sajush. So that sajush shakara also will become room. That is the meaning here. So sajusho room. But our example here is what? Shivaha. So Shivaha, what happens? Shivaha, Shiva plus Su, Prathama Ekvachana, that Vibhakti Pratya, Supratya. This Shivas is because Ukara goes as Shivas. The Sakara is replaced by Ru. So this Sakara, Shivas Sakara is replaced by Ru, and then you get Shivaru. Ukara goes away because it is Anubandha, and then you will get Shivar. What happens to the Shivar Repha? So there, this Repha further, our role ends here because Sashurusho, this is our Sutra right now. But then this Repha will undergo change. That Repha will be getting Adesha of what? Based on what follows, there are further sutras which are needed. So Lagukara moves into the next sutras, Atoror Aplutad Aplute. Because what has he said here? Example, she is not mentioned perhaps. So only Pada has been mentioned. Pada, so at the end of the Pada. Because in this sutra only that much is needed. But if you move on, Shivaha Archyaha. So the real example why he landed on this sutra and did not derive, or why she did not derive, because here also what you should see is this Archya is there. You cannot stop at Shivar. If this is the only example, meaning you start with Shiva plus Su and there is nothing else following, full stop, Avasana, then what will happen? This should be followed through to land into Visarga. But she has not followed through. Why? Because in the Laghu Prakriya, the example he is taking is Shiva not deriving. While deriving Shivar, now should he make it a Visarga or not? There he says, Atoror Aplutad Aplute. Why? Ut Ati. Ati Pare, when At follows. When At follows, what? Ataha, after an At, there is what? Room. So there is At plus Room plus At following. So Room, which is sandwiched between an Akara and another Akara, that Room is replaced by U. Ut. Ut is the Adesha. Taparakarana has been done, meaning short, Ukara is the Adesha. So this is what he has to go to. And for that, what is the example? Shiva is not the example really. The example is Shivaha Archyaha. So Shivaha Archyaha. There, you cannot derive Shiva till Visarga and stop there. So Shivar is where you have derived till Shivaru and then Shivar. Why? After Anubandha Lopa. Upadeshe Janunasikahit Tasya Lopa. So you have landed on Shivar. Shivar and Archya, that is where you are right now. So this much she has already done earlier, Shivar. But this was not mentioned. Otherwise, this would have gone to Visarga. Now what is being said? There is no Avasana. Archya Pada is there. Akara is following. Therefore, At is following. What is it following? It is following Ru Repha. This Ru Repha is preceded by another At. So you have an At plus Ru plus At. Therefore, At, what is this At now? Again, it is Apluta At. It is not At, which is like calling out Ram, Shiva, oh, hey Shiva. It is not that kind of a call. It is not Sambodhana. Otherwise, it would have become Pluta. It is not Pluta. Dirghat. Dirghat Hute. So, Pluta is when calling out from a distance. Sambodhana, called out from a distance, then Akara will also become elongated Trimatrika, Pluta. But it is not Shiva at a distance. You're just calling out Shiva. He is right there in the front. You don't have to give out a call. So Shiva, or not give out a call also. Here what it is not Sambodhana. So it is what? Shivaha Archyaha. So you are saying Shiva is worship worthy, should be worshipped. Shiva should be worshipped. He is Puja Arha. That is the meaning there. Archyaha, Puja Arha Ityartha. So this Ru, which is sandwiched between At and At, will get the Ukara Adesha. So what will happen? Shivar, this Re, Repha is also Ru Repha. So therefore, the Shivar will become Shiva plus U. Now what will happen? These are two separate Padas. So there is a antar bhaya bhava between ukara and akara. If you cannot do sandhi first, you have to do sandhi between this akara and ukara. So ad guna will apply and then you will get shivo. Shivo archaha. And their ing of padantarati will take away this akara and you will get shivo archaha. This avagraha has no pronunciation. It is just, you know, publisher's choice. So really, what is the form? The form is shivorchaha. You cannot pause there. You cannot pronounce the a. If you say shivo, then you have to say shivorchaha. You cannot pause or utter the akara. There are many people who say shivo archaha. Not right. Shivo archaha is not right. Why? Because if you say shivo, then akara is eaten away by ing of padantarati. Because it is what? Purvaha sanhita and purva parayor ekadesha. You cannot use ing of padantarati and make this. Or you have to pause there. Shivo archaha. Then the sandhi itself will not take place. Because samhitayam purva parayor ekah is mandatory. There is no optionality here. So you cannot pause there also. If you make a sandhi, shivo archaha. If you pause, what will happen? Adguna shivo archaha. Shivaha archaha. Then why would you do? If you pause, then why will you say okara? Shivaha archaha. Otherwise, it should be, when there is a sandhi, then you have to, this a cannot be pronounced. Shivorchaha. Hashicha. Aplutad ataha roho ut. Again, aplutad, aplute was there. The following ata also should be apluta. Here also there are counter examples. Kashika usually gives counter example by raising aplutad iti kim, aplute iti kim, then ata iti kim ityadi. Ataha iti kim. Here hashicha. Hashicha is the next sutra, means when a hash letter is following, meaning at is not following, hash is following, and every other condition is same, then also this roo should be replaced by u. It is mandatory. So what is the example? You have this shivo vandyaha, ramo gachati ityadi. So ramaha gachati will become ramo gachati, shivaha vandya will become shivo vandyaha. Why? Because vakara is what? Hash. Just give me a moment. Hush, right? Hush. So Ramo Gachati also. Hush includes till Jabagada Dash. Yeah, Jabagada Dash. Ga will also come in. So Ramo Gachati is also the example for this. The next sutra is Bho Bhago Ago Apurvasya Yoshi Roho. So Roho Adesha. Ru is 6 case singular. So this Ru is this Thani. Ru, which is preceded by bhoho, bhagoho, aghoho, or avarna. Apurvasya is avarna purvasya. No taparakarana has been done. And followed by ash. Then what will happen? Ash will end with what? All vowels, and then hayavarat, jhavai ghadadash. So till the third of the class. Jhavai ghadadash, jabagadadash. Yeah, so jabagadadash, shankar shakara. So you'll have the till the fourth of the class. Fifth and the fourth of the class. So all vowels, hayavarala, then fifth and the fourth of the class. Any of those letters are following, then what will happen? Ru will be replaced by yakara. But it should be preceded by bhoho. Sambodhana, bhoho, bhagoho, agoho. So bhoho is generally used for everyone. Bhagoho is used for what? Actually it is bhos, bhagos, and agos. Sakara at the end of the pada will become visarga, avasane. So therefore those are mentioned, but actually it is what? Bhos, bhagos, and agos. Bhagos is used for sambodhana when you say what? When you want to address Bhagavan. In Shastra you will say addressing someone as Bhagavan. And agos is when somebody wants to point out papa or a loli, or basically it can be for a, you know, some to look down upon someone, agho is used. So it is not sadhu, it should not be used by, you know, unless you are wanting to point that you are a papi. So example is deva iha, deva iha. These are the forms. Why you, this deva ha, sambodhana. This is what? Sambodhana, not first case plural. So this is sambodhana prathama bahuvachana. Only then you will get what? Bho bhago agoho apurva. But it can be an example for apurvasya also. Sorry, not, it need not be sambodhana. It can be first case plural because apurva, avarna. Avarna purvaka, this has been taken as an example. He is not taking bho bhago here. So devaha iha. It can be sambodhana also. Sambodhana is not important here. It can be, may not be. Devaha iha. इह अत्र संति. सो देह इह संति, दैट कैन बी दी वे. और भो देवाः इह इह पश्यतु, इह इह भवतु. सो दैट देवाः भवन्तु, सो भवन्तु पश्यन्तु भवन्तु, दैट कैन बी एडेड एज एज संबोधन डायरेक्टली टॉकिंग टू. और देवाः अत्र संति, अत्र नॉट अत्र बट इह, इह इज बीन यूज्ड देयर. सो इह, सो व्हाट आई सेड, अश, अश इज फॉलोइंग, इकार इज पार्ट ऑफ अश, एंड देवाः इज दिस सकार विच इज रिप्लेस बाय रू. नाउ दिस रू इज वॉट आफ्टर ससोजुशोरु, रू इज देर, एंड देन अपूर्वस्य रू, दिस रू इज वॉट अपूर्व, अ इज अवर्ण, देवा आकार बिफोर द रू इज वॉट अवर्ण, अवर्ण पूर्व रू, दैट अवर्ण पूर्व रू, आ पूर्व रू इज फॉलोड बाय अश, देर फोर दिस यकार इज द आदेश. सो देवा रू इह विल बिकम देवाय इह, देवाय इह. एंड वी हैव ऑलरेडी स्टडीड दिस सूत्र लोपशाकल्य, सो शाकल्य मतेन देर फोर विभाषा, सो देर इज अ विभाषा प्राप्त वा, सो देर बाय यू विल गेट वॉट देवा इह एज ऑप्शनल. सो देर आर टू फॉर्म्स, वन फॉर्म इज देवा इह और देवा इह, दैट इज द फॉर्म हियर, दिस इज द सेकेंड फॉर्म, दिस इज द फर्स्ट फॉर्म, देवा इह. दिस देवा इह कुड बी कन्फ्यूजिंग, वी मे नॉट बी एबल टू मेक आउट वॉट इज दिस, बट दिस सूत्र विल हेल्प अस अंडरस्टैंड दिस पर्टिक्युलर फॉर्म, हियर वी वोंट हैव सच कन्फ्यूजन. नाउ वॉट इज सेड इज द नेक्स्ट सूत्र सेज हलि सर्वेशम. सो नॉट बाय दिस लोप शाकल्य, शाकल्य सेज दैट देर इज लोप वेन अशी, अशी परे, बट वेन हल इज फॉलोइंग, हली परे वॉट सर्वेशम, सर्वेशम मतेन, नॉट ओनली शाकल्यस्य मतेन बट सर्वेशम मतेन लोप कर्तव्य इत्यर्थ. फॉर वॉट, भो भगो अघो अपूर्वस्य यस्य यकारस्य लोप, यकार विच इज प्रिसीडेड बाय भो भग अघो और अवर्ण एंड फॉलोड बाय हल शुड अंडरगो लोप एज पर ऑल. सो एग्जाम्पल इज वॉट, भोस देवाः, भो देवाः, भोरू देवाः, देन भोय देवाः, देन भो देवाः. सो हियर देर इज नो विसर्ग एट ऑल, यकार रू हैज बिकम यकार. सो यू लुक एट दिस, दिस कॉल्ड विसर्ग संधि, इंटरेस्टिंगली ऑल दिस इन विसर्ग संधि, वेर इज द विसर्ग, भो सकार बिकेम रू, रू बिकेम यकार, यकार अंडरवेंट लोप, वेर इज द विसर्ग एट ऑल, बट दिस इज कॉल्ड एज विसर्ग संधि. वाई, बिकॉज इन दी पदा यू लुक एट इट, वेन यू लुक एट इट, भो देवाः इज वॉट यू वॉन्ट टू अटर, बट यू मेक दि संधि, देन यू विल से भो देवाः, विसर्ग विल नॉट साउंड, बट इफ यू लुक एट इट, इट इज टेक्निकली कॉल्ड एज विसर्ग संधि, बट एक्चुअली टेक्निकली इट शुड नॉट बी कॉल्ड एज विसर्ग संधि, इट इज मिसलीडिंग, बट देन भो हैज बीन यूज इन द सूत्र, इट हैज बीन यूज, देर फोर वॉट, विसर्ग इज देर इन द सूत्र, बाय दैट दृष्टि दिस भो, it has been said what, bho, it has, actually visarga is not there in the sutra also, he has used that, use means what, he has used that visarga lopa hali sarvesham, by that rule itself this visarga has gone away, there should have been a visarga which is sakara, it is not a visarga, visarga was never born really, but it is called as visarga sandhi. I am just showing you the it is called as visarga sandhi, but it is, there is no visarga at all, even in the derivation it never became a visarga, without becoming the visarga the room which has become yakara, which is itself born of sakara, sakara repha and then yakara, that yakara went away, there is no visarga at all. We look at the 69 sutra in the next part. I hope to complete this particular book in the and the hal and visarga sandhi in the next part and move on to the next section. Ratavasane nataraja rajo nana dadakkano panchavaram uddharatu kamasanakadi siddha etadvimarsheshu shiva sutra jalam etadvimarsheshu sutra jalam. Namaste, dhanyavada.
Dhanyavada.